She's 8 months old, and Amaya's parents have been searching for childcare her whole life. Her mom starts a new job next month.
She's on multiple wait lists right now, and nothing has really come through.
Tough to find and to pay for.
Definitely, we'll have to compromise on a lot many more things if we want the best care.
Toronto has the highest childcare fees in the country, more than $70 a day for a toddler. Edmonton is around the middle, around $44 a day. Quebec offers the cheapest, less than $10.
Sometimes it even makes me want to think about not going back to work and just staying back and caring for her. But I think about the impact it has on what she'd think about me if her mother, being such a qualified person, just gave up and sat back at home.
Speaking as your finance minister and as a working mother, we will get it done.
Chrystia Freeland was 2 years old when childcare was first declared imperative to women's equality. 50 years later, during a pandemic that's exacerbated the problem, the country's first woman finance minister promises to do what no federal government could in half a century.
High-quality early learning and childcare for an average of $10 a day.
A 50% cut in fees by next year, and childcare for $10 a day by 2026. To make it happen, the Liberals plan to spend $30 billion over the next 5 years, eventually a permanent annual commitment of $8.3 billion, $9.2 if you count previous promises.
If this is something that survives the next election, it could be truly transformative for the sector.
The Liberals are proposing to split childcare fees with the province's 50-50 in order to make this happen. But that will involve more negotiations, and for cash-strapped provinces which don't already heavily invest in childcare, there's no guarantee they'll sign on. Abigail Bimman, Global News, Ottawa.